Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a look at the new Full Keyboard Access feature in macOS Monterey. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a new accessibility feature in macOS is called Full Keyboard Access. And the idea here is to give access to everything on the screen using just your keyboard. Now through keyboard shortcuts and other techniques, you already have access to most things using the keyboard without turning this on. This aims to kind of fill the gap so you have access to just about everything. But it's very new and it doesn't quite work as you would expect sometimes. So to turn it on, you want to go into System Preferences and then go to Accessibility. Then scroll down to Keyboard. And you'll see here under Navigation, Enable Full Keyboard Access. Let's look at the options first. So for Appearance options, you have the number of seconds to hide full keyboard access. You also can increase the size and contrast of the indicator. This is going to be the box surrounding things when you're selecting them. You can also set the color. You can also go here to see all these different commands. There are a lot of different ways to see these commands. You can see them here. You also can see some of them listed right here. And as we'll find out when you use the Tab H shortcut, you can see all of them as well. Let's enable this. So when I enable it, now you can see this blue outline here around this control. And as you can see, a lot of the different commands involve the Tab key. So to move forward, I use Tab. And you can see how it jumped from here to there. And I can continue to move forward using Tab. And it will loop back around and you can see it winds up back here. Now inside this I can move around using the arrow keys here. So I can go up and down and you can see that the thing still selected in this case is keyboard. So if I want to switch to another selection I have to activate it using space. So you can see now I'm in pointer control. I can go back up to keyboard but to activate it space. So it's kind of like when you move the pointer with your mouse or trackpad over something. That's not active. You actually have to click to go there. The same thing here. The arrow key is kind of like moving this full keyboard access pointer over this other item, in this case keyboard, and space is kind of like clicking to select it. Now when we use Tab H, and there are going to be some basic commands here, and I can use the arrow keys to navigate up and down and to the right. So here are the basic commands. I can see under movement, here are the movement commands. You can see a lot of these involve either Tab, the arrow keys, Tab and the arrow keys to go to the beginning and end of groups, or Control Tab. Now I can go to Interaction and see here that to activate something I use a space. Contextual menu, that is Tab M. So you have a way basically to right click using Tab as a modifier key. That's something new. And then M will bring up the context menu. And other actions can be accomplished by using Tab Z. And then here we see Device and we'll see some special commands to get to various things that are really hard to get to with the keyboard. And we'll look at these in a minute. So here we are in the Finder and we can see the group selected is the list of files. I can use the arrow keys to move through it but it's important to realize I haven't selected anything. This light blue highlight here is part of full keyboard access. It's not what's selected. To select something I need to use the space bar. And now I've selected it. Another thing to realize is that full keyboard access relies heavily on the regular keyboard shortcuts. So just because you use full keyboard access to select this item doesn't mean you should use anything special to actually do something with it. All of the regular keyboard shortcuts that you might use to say open this folder would apply here. So Command O is what opens the folder and Command up arrow is what goes up a level on the Finder. So it's important to master those keyboard shortcuts that are available all the time before using full keyboard access to actually do things that you couldn't normally do. Here I am in Safari and you can see part of the page has been selected. So I can now tab through the various parts of the page. And it's a little tricky. Sometimes you just have to keep tabbing through to see where you get. But once you have something selected you can actually click on it using the space bar and it's the same as clicking on that link. And then it's useful to know all of the regular Safari keyboard shortcuts. For instance, Command left square bracket is back. Now if we want to right click or control click on the item, we can do Tab M, and you can see now you're in the context menu. And I could use the arrow keys to navigate through here to select something. Also, you've got Tab Z will bring up actions. So actions show you what's possible here. In this case, I can arrow down to press and make it act like a click, or show menu to make it act like a control click or right click. You use the escape key a lot while working with this to get out of those menus. Now one of the things that you can do in full keyboard access that's almost impossible to do elsewhere is access things like notifications and control center. So for notifications, it's the FN or globe key and N. And this will bring up notifications, and notice it has that blue outline around it. I can now tab through the items here and actually use the arrow keys inside of groups to access things. Let's shift tab back here to this notification, and I can now use tab Z and we'll bring up actions, and you can see I can do close or press. So I'm going to close that, and it's the equivalent to clicking the X. Now you can also bring up Control Center with the FN key and C. And this will go to the Control Center. And as far as I know, this is the only way to access Control Center using the keyboard. Previously there was no way to do it at all. So now you can do this and tab through the different groups. And if I were to click on this, it will turn Bluetooth off, right? So normally what I would do is control click on it. And if I'm unsure, I can just use Tab Z and it will show details or press. So let's do show details. And you can see now it digs down into Bluetooth. Now you can access the menu bar using control and F2. In this case, I need to use the FN key for F2 to not be the screen brightness key. So now that I'm in the menu bar, I can use the arrow keys to move around and down and select any menu item I want. If you want to access the dock, it's the FN key and A. And this will access the dock, and you can move through the different items. You can even go up to select things that are in the context menu there. A couple other interesting things. One is you can use Mission Control with the keyboard this way. And as far as I know, there was no way to use Mission Control with just the keyboard before. Oh, sure, you can do Control Up Arrow to access it. You really need to use the mouse or trackpad and pointer to be able to do things. But now you can actually use Tab to go through the different items. And I've got some on the other screen here. But eventually we'll loop back here to these. And for instance, if I wanted to go to this one, I could use the space bar. So I could Control Up Arrow, tab over to the one that I want, and space bar to jump to it. Now if you have a window selected, like I have the Finder selected here, if I do Tab Z, I'll see that there are no additional actions. So I'm not quite sure how you would use this to actually, say, move one thing to another desktop or go full screen or remove full screen. So the bottom line here is this is a really interesting new feature, and I hope it continues to evolve and work better in some cases. If you're someone that needs full keyboard access to your Mac, then certainly it's an improvement over what was there before. In particular, being able to access things like Control Center and Notification Center. It seems to me to be very difficult to use to know when you should be using Tab or the arrow keys or space or some other keyboard command to get something done. Probably after a day or two, I would get used to using it. There is one last thing I want to show you. If you do Tab H for help and you go down to Device, notice the last one is Pass-Through Mode. So Control Option Command P. So what this does is it temporarily turns off full keyboard access. So you use that keyboard command and you have this indicator telling you that Pass-Through Mode is now on. So now that turns off full keyboard access and gives you back regular control. This is a way to prevent full keyboard access from getting in the way temporarily when you want to do something like use a complex app or a game, and then being able to quickly just turn it back on so that you have full keyboard access back again. So if you just want to use this for something like, say, accessing Control Center with the keyboard, you can have it on with pass-through mode on all the time. And then if you want to access the Control Center, you could quickly do Control Option Command P and then FNC to get to Control Center, and then Tab to get to what you want. And when you're done with Control Center, you can just do Control Option Command P again, and then pass-through mode is on again. Now note that some of the new shortcuts actually work even if full keyboard access is turned off. For instance, you could hold the FN or globe key and then A, and the dock will appear. And you can use the arrow keys to go back and forth and actually select something in the dock with the space bar. You could also use the FN or globe key and C to bring up Control Center. But with full keyboard access turned off, there's really nothing you can do with it. You can look at it, but you can't actually navigate with the arrow keys or tab key to do anything. The FN globe key also works with the M key to go to the menu bar, and here you actually can navigate. So this is the same as doing Control F2 or Control FN F2 depending upon your keyboard settings. You get exactly the same result. It's just a different keyboard shortcut that matches the one in full keyboard access. And you can use the FN or globe key and N to bring up Notification Center. But like Control Center, there's nothing you can do with it here. You can't navigate around with the arrows or tab. You can just bring it up. But that could be handy to quickly see some notifications and then use the same thing to dismiss it. So if you think this would be useful to you, then give it a try. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.